Welcome to the Antique Automobile Club of America Museum in Hershey, Pennsylvania, and our special exhibit, Lotus, the Art of Lightness, where we hope to educate the public on the history of Lotus and the history of Lotus engineering. This is the Lotus Type 79, a groundbreaking Formula One design that reset the paradigm of what a Formula One car should be. It pioneered the use of ground effect aerodynamics in Formula One racing. The primary feature that's visible on this car that the viewer can see is the side pods, which have venturis to create downforce, and the sliding skirts underneath them that literally touch the ground to aid in the aerodynamic efficiency. Most everybody knows about the existence of the DeLorean DMC-12, but what most people don't know is that the DMC-12 was engineered by Lotus for DeLorean so it could go into production. The Lotus 11, an iconic Lotus design which dominated sports car racing in the United Kingdom and Europe in the late 50s, also winning a class at Le Mans multiple times and setting a world speed record in its displacement category. The 95T is the first Team Lotus Formula One car designed by Gérard Decarouge from the ground up. Gérard was brought in after Colin Chapman's death to resurrect the team. It was not particularly successful, but it was the first design in a series of cars that eventually became successful. Team Lotus won the next year with the 97T. And what's different about this car compared to the 79 is the lack of sliding skirts, and it has a flat bottom, as the venturis and the sliding skirts had been outlawed by the FIA at this point. The Lotus 18 is a significant car in Lotus history because it was the first successful Formula car that they had made. It was available in three levels: the Formula Junior, Formula 2, and Formula 1. It was extremely successful in Formula Junior in the hands of people like Jim Clark, and it was extremely successful in Formula 1 in the hands of Stirling Moss, driving for Rob Walker's private team. This is my personal Lotus Type 69. It's in Formula 2 specification, and it's an absolute thrill to drive. It gives a fantastic amount of mechanical grip, it gives aerodynamic downforce, and it's a chassis that'll handle the power. And when I'm driving it, it's more fun than I've had in any other car that I've ever driven. Lotus Esprit World Championship Commemorative Edition, celebrating the Formula One World Championship won by Mario Andretti and the Lotus Type 79. The M100 Elan, the first and only front-wheel drive Lotus. Lotus Exige S260, the ultimate track Exige. The Corvette ZR1 with a 32-valve, 4-cam, all-aluminum, Lotus-designed V8 engine. In the early 1960s, Lotus's West Coast distributor, Ecurie Shirley, owned by Bob Shulman, ran a series of ads in Road and Track that all featured artwork by John Dahlstrom. One of these ads, Lotus Racing Sets, advertised the set for $19,885. And the four cars represented in the ad are represented here today: a Lotus 7 Series 2 America, a Type 14 Elite, Type 22 Formula Junior, and Type 23 Sports Racing Car. PPG was a longtime sponsor of the IndyCar World Series, and for the 1997 and 1998 seasons, they put together a group of road cars to act as pace cars for the series. This 1997 Lotus Esprit V8 was one such car, and characteristically, it was the only car capable of pacing the field at 150 miles an hour around Michigan International Speedway. The Mark VI is the first Lotus with a bespoke chassis designed by Colin Chapman. The Lotus Elan is 50 years old and still sets the standard for sports cars today. The Ford Consul Cortina by Lotus, more commonly known as the Lotus Cortina, a family car that was transformed by Lotus into a championship-winning saloon car. The Lotus Type 110 time trial bicycle. 1972 Lotus Europa Twin Cam and 1972 Lotus Elan Sprint. In the middle, we have a Lotus Elan chassis. The backbone chassis is the basis for all Lotuses from the 1962 Lotus Elan all the way through the 2004 Lotus Esprit V8.
Kyle is the man, and without him, you know, he came to me about a year or so ago, and we had the Porsche display, it was ending, and he was here at the Castaway Critter Show in April and said, you know, maybe we gotta think about doing something with Lotus. I said, okay. And the rest is history, but Kyle was able to reach out to everybody and get all the cars here, did the write-ups on the cars, and everything. So we really, really owe him a great round of applause.
Thank you, Mark. It's hard to believe that, as Mark said a couple years ago, I just dropped off my card and said, if you ever want to do a Lotus exhibit, give me a call. I know some people and I have some cars. And the next thing you know, I'm curating it and getting all the cars and doing all the write-ups. And it was 100% enjoyable 100% of the time. Mark already thanked the people who put their cars in, but I need to thank him again. Most of these people are my friends, and I just called them up and said, hey, I'm doing an exhibit in a museum. Would you put your car in? And there was no hesitance at all. It's like, absolutely, I'll put it in. All you had to do was ask. So I'm really thrilled about that. As Mark said, I wrote the placards, and it was very difficult for me to do that because I have a fairly large breadth of knowledge, and I wasn't sure if I needed to write something that would be for the general public or for the car enthusiast or for the Lotus enthusiast. I'm hoping that regardless of which group you're in, you'll read the placards, you'll go through the museum, and you'll come away with it with a new appreciation for Lotus cars. This exhibit should not be about me at all. It really is about Lotus cars. And I'm doing it because it's my major hobby. My wife, God bless her, fully supports it. Every time I talk about trying to sell one of my cars, she tells me not to, if you can believe it. So I really need to thank my wife, Irina. And if anybody sees a young lad in a Lotus Racing driver suit running around, that's my son. So in summary, I'd really like to thank everybody who's here. I recognize a lot of faces because they're Lotus owners and they're in the Lotus Club, and there's many more people that I don't recognize, and I hope you enjoy what we put together here. Thank you very
Thanks,
much.
Thanks, Kyle. Well, once again, I want to thank everybody for coming out. This is actually our largest opening reception ever.
Down the days of fear, chasing down a dream before it disappeared. I was aching to be somewhere near. Your voice was all I heard. I was shaking from a storm in me, haunted by the specters that we had to see. Yeah, I wanted to be the melody above the noise, above the hurt. I was young.